Welcome to the Banff World Media Festival. Your session is about to begin.
Thank you, and good afternoon. It's great to be here this afternoon and have the opportunity to share the stage with some of these wonderfully talented speakers. Want to thank the folks at Banff, Amy, Jesse, and the team for the opportunity to be here. My name is Will Campbell, and as Amy indicated, I'm the head of digital at Muse Communications, a Los Angeles-based agency, where I oversee our digital practice called Quantasy, where we specialize in branded entertainment, branded content, social media, digital marketing. I hope that today what I have to share can add some value or shed some light on some of the things that many of you are involved with and working on as we brave this new media world. In today's rapidly evolving global business environment, we've learned that past approaches just don't do the job. In every imaginable category, whether marketer side or media side, competition, technology, emerging business models, new lifestyles and attitudes have thoroughly disrupted our traditional brand building processes. The usual approaches to advertising, brand building, media, even entertainment, no longer work the way they did. No one wants to see stuff like this anymore. So what has changed is part of a massive cultural shift in the way people connect with and relate to the companies, products, and brands that are important to them. Consumers, your audience, and the people who will become your customers want to connect and communicate with your brand in different ways. Even the levers that appear to be fresh, like digital marketing, work very differently today than they did just 5 years ago. Gross impressions and cost per thousand hardly mean anything in a world where you must communicate and connect with a subset of your audience's peers. Today's consumer is an on-demand consumer. They want what they want, when they want, and wherever they want it. And they consistently choose what is custom tailored for their lifestyle. In this experience, they want to be in the moment and uniquely designed for the experience that they are within at that point. They've determined that their gut instinct is a real contributor to what is right. So if it feels right, it is right. And if I'm emotionally connected, then it's right for me. That presents problems for us marketers, and we try everything to connect with this audience. Some of us try to use strategy to outsmart them. Then there are those that run to the next Pinterest or the next Twitter or the next Instagram, trying to chase them down. Some of us don't even know where our audience is. And there's others of us that just react. But alas, the rise of content marketing, branded entertainment, lifestyle marketing, and social media to face this new reality. Give them something that they'll like, something that they'll talk about. The convergence of Madison Avenue, Hollywood, and Silicon Valley have provided us with an amazing opportunity to connect with consumers in different ways. And we've begun to leverage this convergence to better connect with our consumers. Advertising, entertainment, and technology have truly become the new levers for success. We can now give them what they want and what they like and something to talk about. But as with anything, new approaches bring new questions and new challenges. Things like, how do we really achieve real ROI when we can't afford to just entertain for the fun of it? Or how do we infuse our message so that's organic and authentic? I'd like to talk today about the world of culture and the role that culture can play as a fourth lever to rebalance how we approach content and how we successfully applied some of this thinking for American Honda Motor Corporation when they wanted to reach a highly discerning multicultural young adult audience. So why culture? Why is culture part of the equation? Because in today's world, audiences are fragmented. Emerging technology, the ubiquity of distribution have caused an immense shattering of the media landscape. And when it comes to how to segment and how to target their market, the numbers are deceiving, also known as confusing. And this is more often than not because we are not properly analyzing the data. Fact, 6 out of 5 marketers have problems with fractions. What that means is, while we're looking at a main target, we may often overlook the opportunity to connect with a bigger group for our audience based on microcultural sectors. So this means that if you market to one segment who you think is your target, you may risk not connecting with a large opportunity. For example, Little Centrum Silver here. So recently, on behalf of American Honda, we took on these new challenges and have been able to successfully reimagine the possibilities and harness the opportunity this new reality brings. In 2010, we were faced with what seemed to be the lofty goal of creating purchase consideration for the Honda Accord among the highly coveted, highly discerning young adult audience. This audience was self-aware, had grown up empowered, was 30-something, earning, educated, and vocal. So in pursuing this audience, we realized and sat down with the client and determined that there had to be some clear rules of engagement on how we moved forward to manage this. Rule number one, don't interrupt the moment. So no matter what you have to say, how valid you think it is, if you interrupt the moment, you'll be resented for it, period. Rule number two, be authentic. So in this case, this means be authentic to the brand, be authentic to who you are, be authentic to the consumer, and be authentic to the culture. You have to determine what's right for you. And the last rule, which is the most scientific of all.
Don't be an idiot. Changed my life. Whenever I'm about to do something, I think, would an idiot do that? And if they would, I do not do that thing.
Don't be an idiot. Use common sense. Communicate the way people communicate. Talk the way people talk. If you make a mistake, apologize. If someone shows you credit, say thank you. There's some easy ways to solve problems with just basic communication. So we believe that there are 3 main principles in activating this 4th cultural lever to make an impact with your content marketing. These 3 principles are values, stories, and connections. The first principle is values, is where it all starts. A value, simply put, is something that's important to me. This is something that becomes important to consumers. It could be anything from my family, career success, being a good mom, etc. These are the things that we find in basic research insights. But what we had to do is take an opportunity to look at the values of the marketer and the consumer, know what's important to both so we can create the right balance and solve some of those challenges of the tug of war in terms of branded content. So the output of this first principle is identifying the shared value. When this came to American Honda, we wanted to identify the shared value for the Honda Accord. At the time, a few things were happening within this sector. One, automakers like BMW and Lexus were building and distributing lower trim luxury vehicles that were intruding on the price range of the Honda Accord, giving this 30-something an opportunity for a taste of luxury. On the other end of the spectrum, there was this huge cultural shift to a new mindset. Things like environmentally friendly were becoming extremely popular. You had the rise of the Prius, and these behaviors were completely committed to by the audience. This shift in consciousness demonstrated an idea of smart is the new cool. So our audience started shedding things like bling and big rims and things like that to really focus on more cause-related activities, and thrift shopping became popular and the rise of the hipster. And as huge cultural icons like Jay-Z were changing what they were doing, for example, in his song 30-something, where he says, I don't buy the bright watch, I buy the right watch, and began trading in his bling for spectacles and blazers. What we determined was The real finding here, the real value, was style that makes sense. And this was something that was true to the Honda brand for years. Honda had been always credited for being dependable, reliable, and making quality vehicles. So the concept of style that made sense was a value at this point in time that resonated for both the marketer and the consumer. So now we had something that was an authentic representation of the brand perspective as well as the consumers. We call this the unique shared value. Having identified this unique shared cultural value, we could then tell a story from that point of view without the distraction of how to infuse our message. It was inherently included based on us determining this shared value system. It wasn't about trying to convince the audience, it was about starting with something that we agreed on. For this became an agreement with the audience as opposed to a trade-off. Second principle in activating culture is creating stories from shared values. So once we have that shared value, we take that and create the story from it. Again, this keeps us authentic. And we have to create a story in a way that didn't scream, Honda Accord is all about style that makes sense. We looked for a true occurrence of this story within the culture. Enter Mickey Fax. Mickey Fax was a young up-and-coming artist from the Bronx, New York. And so as we looked at music, which had proven to be one of the strongest emotional connections for our audience, we knew that we couldn't turn to a celebrity. We couldn't turn to a Jay-Z or a big shot Hollywood star to represent the Honda Accord. It just wasn't authentic. So Mickey Fax was this up-and-coming artist that had established a strong social following online through Twitter and Facebook and had become well-known in the magazines for his fashion style and his unique style in music. Additionally, this was solidified by Honda's corporate message of the power of dreams as Mickey Fax, this young artist from the Bronx, was pursuing his music career, following his dream on his own. The objective was to have the audience become more closely connected to the sentiment of having style that makes sense. It just made sense, and it was authentic and true. So we gave him a car and followed him on his journey as a web series. He didn't talk much about Honda, and he didn't discuss product features. Here we had a story that was already a topic of conversation within the culture, and we had a relevant point of view as it inherently represented what we've been known for. We added the texture of additional shared values like hard work and quality into the story to convey the brand perspective and appeal to the consumer's interests. The third and final principle of activating culture is in connections. Connections is about enabling fluidity across platforms. We look at distribution channels as part of the experience, not just a medium. To effectively harness the power of the fluidity in branded content, we consider every touch point where the consumer will want to experience the story. So in this case, we developed specific mobile content against the story and created the mobile content where it was broken out in smaller chunks and connected with real-time commenting so as to experience this content when on a mobile phone. We developed a website where we included editorial content and style tips and style information and photo galleries to continue the opportunity to understand style that makes sense over and beyond just the vehicle. The five-part series culminated with a contest. And here's a trailer on
how to first time I've ever been to a site, the fat cat interrupts me. Showing me. Sometimes it takes events like that to happen in order for someone else to turn into a tiger.
Rapping is my job, so I work, work. See, it's the reason I was put upon this earth, earth. My friends and my family say I'm a jerk, jerk.
I understand that, but we gotta pick a record right now.
Hurst, hurst. I got this.
it to the right person only gives you an opportunity to listen. And sometimes you might get that opportunity, but if the record ain't ready, it ain't ready. Believe in your dreams and you continuously work towards your dreams and won't let nobody stop you or hinder you, after a while you will definitely become your dream.
Somebody once came to me and said, if there was something other than music that I want to do in my life, then I should try and go and do it, because music isn't easy. Well, the truth is, this is what feeds me. It's the reason why I wake up every morning.
Overall, the program recorded over 9 million views, millions of impressions. It was picked up across many of the hip-hop, fashion, and music blogs. So with that, in summary, a few points to walk away with. One, re-envision culture, tell stories about it, be honest and authentic, and fulfill connections outrageously. Thank you.